This is the all-new Chrome OS Flex. Google has finally brought its cloud-centric superfast OS from its Chromebooks to PCs and Macs, but with a few twists here and there. I've been a long-time Chrome OS user, and it's a completely different way of using a computer. Chrome OS is a simple, fast, and secure operating system that was designed for the modern, always-connected world. It's just brilliant. You don't worry about updates, battery life, or your files with Chrome OS. Rather, you work faster, play better, and this amazing experience is now available right on your computers with Chrome OS Flex. So let's jump right in and see what exactly Chrome OS Flex is, how it performs, what kind of apps you can install on it, the user interface, what advantages Chrome OS Flex brings for you, how is it better than other operating systems, how is it different from Chrome OS, can you game on it, how to install and use Chrome OS Flex. We're answering all the questions, so let's start off. So what exactly is this Chrome OS Flex? Chrome OS Flex is a fast and lightweight Linux-based operating system created by Google. It is a web-first system, meaning it focuses on working with web applications. Google's Chrome browser is the central element of this operating system. The Chrome OS experience, which was exclusive on Chromebooks till now, is made available to other computers with this. You can download and install Chrome OS Flex on your computer right now. To give you a little context of Chrome OS, it is famous for its remarkably simple and super speedy experience, and it has been very popular with nearly 100 million Chromebooks sold in the last 3 years. Chrome OS Flex has its lineage in Chrome OS and another operating system called Cloud Ready, which was created by a company called Neverware, both of which are in turn based on the Chromium OS Project. And this is the user interface of the new Chrome OS Flex. One of the enticing reasons to use Chrome OS Flex is its simple, sleek interface that is so easy to use. No matter if you're coming from Windows or Mac background, you'll feel at home here very quickly. The home screen features a bottom panel with your favorite web apps, fully customizable with drag and drop. Then we get a system tray with important system controls and notifications here. Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, volume, and a few other things are given here, and this lets you control your system with just a few clicks. Then comes the launcher. Now this is a masterstroke for Chrome OS Flex. This launcher houses all your apps. The top section is pinned with the last 4 files you have worked with, both on this system and on your Google account. So it's really easy to get back to work. In fact, this launcher reminds and encourages you to get back to work. Then the search is just amazing. We can search for apps installed on the system, search the web with Google, directly jump to our most visited and favorite websites, go to certain settings directly, and search for files on your system. As you start typing, these results are displayed and they are categorized very nicely so that you can get what exactly you want. With this search, the workflow gets so much faster, and personally, I know I'm more productive on my Chromebook for certain tasks. The user interface of Chrome OS has little features that make day-to-day experience better. Any file you download will be pinned here on the bottom shelf for quick access. Navigation, getting around the system, is another area where Chrome OS has always been superior to other operating systems. Firstly, the trackpad is used brilliantly with so many gestures available. We all use single finger for moving the cursor, two fingers for scrolling and zooming and options. Chrome OS Flex has 3-finger gestures for switching between tabs and apps. Then we get 4-finger swipes for switching between desks or workspaces. While I don't really use 4-finger swipes a lot, but I absolutely love 3-finger gestures on my Chromebook. It really makes working so much faster, and I really feel more efficient at my work. Then we also get Google Assistant. It wakes up on OK Google or Hey Google, and does whatever you ask it to. This makes basic tasks like checking conversion rates, doing basic calculations, or getting some quick information very convenient and quick. It can do so much more, like creating and opening documents, searching and opening files from your Google Drive, working with your calendar, changing device settings like turning on the Bluetooth or changing the brightness, play music, send emails, and so much more. Once you start using this assistant, you're really going to appreciate it. Overall, talking about the user interface, the looks and feel of Chrome OS Flex, we get a completely modern, colorful, productivity-oriented, yet really simple desktop, and I can't see anybody not falling in love with this. Chrome OS is known for its superfast performance and that quick boot up, and Chrome OS Flex delivers the same snappy performance. Chromebooks are generally inexpensive devices that use very low powered processors, but you never see any lags or freezes. I'm not exaggerating, but the experience of using a Chromebook may be better than many laptops. That's mainly because Chrome OS is very lightweight and by design, responsiveness is prioritized heavily here. We should also remember that basically, Chrome browser is the only application running here. It's more complicated than that actually, but it is the only user application running. When we say responsiveness, applications open up before we even properly finish clicking on the icon. Yeah, Chrome OS Flex is that fast. Switching between apps, tabs feels so smooth. Working with Google Docs, creating presentations, watching videos, everything is effortlessly fast here. And the boot up times are so good on all my computers. Chrome OS Flex starts up and is ready for use in less than 5 seconds if installed on SSD. Hard disk drives need a bit more time, but they are amazingly fast nevertheless. Now talking about the raw performance as in benchmarks or compiling or gaming, that completely depends on your hardware and I don't really think that matters a lot as Chrome OS Flex is not designed to be used for compiling the Linux kernel or running The Witcher 3 natively. I'm not saying you can't, but if you use Chrome OS Flex for what it is intended to, that is working with web applications, you'll be more than satisfied. You'll actually fall in love with how smooth it is. Chrome OS Flex is specifically suggested for older laptops and desktops by Google. This will significantly lengthen the lifetime of these old computers. And even on these, the performance is pretty impressive. Overall, for performance, Chrome OS Flex scores top points. Chrome OS Flex focuses on working with web applications primarily. And this is where you're in for a wild experience. The world has gone digital, we are better connected, and the web is evolving rapidly. Websites are not static pages of information anymore like the early days of the internet. Today, websites are so much more. They are used to run businesses, do banking, to communicate, to edit photos and videos. In fact, there is hardly anything left for which there isn't a website. You can play high-end games like Cyberpunk 2077 online today. Google has been working intensely in bringing the power of the cloud to the user, making the experience of working online more seamless, and Chrome OS Flex does this brilliantly. For Office, you get Google Docs. You can work with Word files, presentations, and Excel sheets. And they work offline too. Then, they're absolutely free, so that's great for students too. Google obviously provide all their apps here. Then, we can install many additional applications from Chrome Web Store. We have everything from photo and video editors to games here. You get to choose from thousands of apps across many categories. Many of these apps work offline, but you get the best experience on Chrome OS Flex when connected to the internet. Since Chrome OS Flex is powered by the Linux kernel, we can install and run Linux apps here. This significantly widens the domain of what can be done on Chrome OS Flex. Most Linux apps run here without any issues. You need to enable Linux environment from the settings and then you can use the apt command to install apps. We get Android apps on Chrome OS, but they are not yet available here in Flex. I hope we get them in later versions as some Android apps bring fantastic functionality to Chrome OS. Chrome OS Flex is essentially a web-centric system and while working with web applications has its minimal limitations, it definitely has some amazing benefits too. Web apps are generally more affordable, there's no installation hassle, they work on every system with an internet connection irrespective of the PC specs, they can be used on multiple devices seamlessly and the files are stored in the cloud, which in itself is a huge benefit. I can talk all day about this, but you have to experience it firsthand and then decide if it's for you or not. Of course, you need to give it some time to adjust to this style of computing. Chrome OS Flex is a great system for entertainment. For online media consumption, it's pretty much the same as any other system running a browser. Netflix, Prime, YouTube all offer the same experience here. Chrome OS Flex gives us amazing battery life, so watching movies is uninterrupted and better. Games. Well, we can game on Chrome OS Flex, but it's a tad bit different story. Chrome Web Store has some really cool games which can be fantastic time killers. Cut the Rope, Free Rider, Interland, Swoop, 8 Ball Pool, and the list just goes on. Retro gaming section here has some amazing entries. Of course, gaming is limited here by the underlying technology and hardware might. Chrome OS was never intended or even needed to run on powerful hardware, so games are rather basic graphics-wise. But the fun we can have is not limited. Of course, you can play AAA titles here with cloud gaming services like Stadia, Cyberpunk 2077, Red Dead Redemption 2, Doom, and many more fantastic games are available there. And since Linux apps are supported here, you can install many Linux games here. And the interesting part is, you can install Steam and Steam games too. But if your computer is low powered, the gaming experience might not be that enjoyable. Advantages and disadvantages. Both are big here. We get big advantages, then there are some big disadvantages too. We get a very lightweight, fast system. This system is designed for productivity. The battery lasts super long, updates are automatic and don't need any user input. If you have a computer that is old and slow, Chrome OS Flex is going to make that very usable. We have already covered what makes Chrome OS Flex an amazing computing system today. Moving on to disadvantages, you cannot install Windows apps. While it's absolutely possible for most people to live without Windows apps, it can be a little difficult at first. And if you need to use certain software that are exclusive to Windows, like those from Adobe, Chrome OS Flex may not be for your main system. Then you need to be online always. Chrome OS Flex gives us the best experience when connected to the internet. Without an internet connection, it becomes unusable very fast. Chrome OS Flex is a Google proprietary software. It's not open source in its final form. True, it is based on the Chromium OS, which is open source, but the final Flex version is not. Now this might be a deal breaker for some people. Chrome OS Flex is made for everybody and is fantastic for the general computational needs of most people. But if you have a need for specialized software or hardware, Chrome OS Flex becomes irrelevant. That being said, Chrome OS Flex is great if you have old hardware. That is the intended primary use case. Then, Chrome OS Flex is just amazing for students. Students have been the biggest audience of Chromebooks as the benefits they bring to students are phenomenal. Chrome OS Flex is very good for seniors. There's no maintenance hassle here, it cannot be broken that easily and updates on its own. And it's so easy to use with even Google Assistant support. Then, Chrome OS Flex is fantastic for businesses. It's free and if your business software can be run in a browser, most of which are, then Chrome OS Flex makes more sense than anything else out there. You need to give it a try, install it and use it for some time. Then you can decide for sure. At the moment, Chrome OS Flex is still in developer early access, so make sure not to install it on critical systems. Chrome OS and Chrome OS Flex sound the same and look the same, but there are certain distinctions between the two. Chrome OS Flex does not support Android apps. Chrome OS does, but the Flex version doesn't. I hope Android apps come here soon, as certain Android apps and games are really fantastic on Chromebooks. Moving on, Chromebooks are very secure as they have dedicated hardware and technologies to protect them. Chrome OS Flex 2 is very secure, but there are differences due to the absence of Google's security chip. The overall experience too may vary in terms of performance and stability between Chrome OS and Chrome OS Flex. First of all, Chrome OS Flex at the time of making this video is in early access. It's for testing purposes only and should not be deployed in critical and production environments. Then, Chrome OS Flex on some hardware, it works flawlessly. On some, it has minor issues, and on some hardware, it's not even possible to boot into the OS. This might change in the future. Google has a certified models list where they are going to individually certify and maintain a list of models that you can use with Chrome OS Flex. I've linked the list in the description below. You can check the status of your laptop there. Even if it's not on the list, you can give it a try. You can try Flex in a live session without installing anything, so you get a good idea of how Flex runs on your computer. Okay, how do we install Chrome OS Flex? Chrome OS Flex installation is extremely simple. First, you need to install a Chrome extension called Chromebook Recovery Utility. This works on Mac and Windows. It doesn't work on Linux. Then, plug in the pen drive that you want to use. From the drop-down, select Google Chrome Flex. Select this here and go. This will download and install Chrome OS Flex on the USB stick. Then you need to restart your computer and boot into the pen drive using boot device selection. Once the pen drive boots, you can either try Chrome OS Flex or install it. The install option erases your hard disk and install flex. That's it. There are no other options or anything. If you click on install, it just installs the OS. While the installation is simple, I would have liked more options like the install location during installation. Once installed, you can log in with your Google account and start using Chrome OS Flex. Personally, I use a Chromebook on a daily basis and I love working on Chrome OS. The benefits are real. I really enjoy that fast and streamlined workflow. But then, I only use it for certain tasks. I cannot replace my desktop with it. I'm running Ubuntu and Fedora on my main system right now, and that's where a good portion of my work gets done. But for most of my online work, Chrome OS it is. To sum things up, Chrome OS Flex is a great option for devices that are low-powered, old, and need to be easy to manage, maybe for students or seniors. It's perfect for tasks like browsing the web, checking email, and using online tools. With the rise of cloud-based services, Chrome OS Flex is the perfect operating system for people that want to take advantage of the cloud, in homes, educational institutes, as well as businesses. More and more of the software that I use are being replaced by cloud services, and it's obviously because the experience they provide is that much better. Chrome OS Flex is still in early access, therefore it is buggy on many laptops, but I have high hopes for its future. I'm confident about it too. If you enjoyed this video, if you found it helpful, do consider subscribing to my channel and also turn on notifications. Next up, check out the all new Peppermint OS 11, which is yet another lightweight, high performance operating system that I really liked. This is Linux Techs signing out.